Hey folks, this is Burst and Slot, and welcome to today's very, very long Planet Zoo video. This is an hour and 10 minutes-ish just for the speed build, and then of course we'll have a little walk around in person, so it's going to be a long video. Go get yourself a drink or a snack or whatever you want to do, and let's get started with today's build. So, yeah, surprise, two Planet Zoo episodes in a week's time. That's, you know, unheard of these days, I know, to say the very least. But as with the lodge that we built last time, I was just kind of feeling it. Now, the reason this is so long is because this build, I think, was probably the longest build I've ever done, now that I think about it. About 13 to 14 hours, you know, I lost a little bit of the content. 13 to 14 hours to completion, not including all the time I spent in Photoshop doing various signs and stuff like that. So it was a long, long, long build because I wanted to build a building. I've said build too many times already. Not allowed to say it for the next hour. I wanted to make a building interior, like a proper actual interior. So we talked about this in the last video, but the idea is to build a diner, the Odia diner from Alan Wake. It wasn't called the Odia diner in Alan Wake 1, but in Alan Wake 2, the Odia diner, because I felt like a diner with, you know, like all the dumpsters behind it and stuff like that was a really cool environment for a bear. I really wanted to have the sloth bear in our park, and I figured, well, bears encroach from the wilderness and they go and they explore, you know, the trash. So a diner makes a lot of sense to fit with that, and also it means I get to play with some neon, and I love playing with neon. So first thing I'm doing here is building, sort of sketching out, I would call it, almost with my path, kind of trying to get like a feel for the wider layout. Basically, there's going to be a car park to the side of the diner, and then behind the car park, or next to the car park, there's going to be a little dumpster sort of area. And this is also the car parking for the entire town, because there's no car parking anywhere else, so everyone has to park here. I used a couple of different workshop items in this build. I think I only used vehicles, now that I think about it, but they will, everyone who built one of those items will be credited during the walk around portion, because I've built like a little memorial section to them inside the diner eventually. But yeah, initially there's just a lot of thinking, trying to, terrifying as that is, I know, just trying to plan out where exactly things were going to go and what was going to sit to the right hand side. The main thing I'm trying to get across at the moment is to make this town feel a little bit more like an actual town, to feel like, you know, there's enough buildings that people live here. So I brought in the roads a little bit. The road is going to end here. Initially, it did move down here, and we're going to do some houses on the far side. I might just reuse my ones from the Halloween build we did, because they feel pretty appropriate. But I want like little rows of houses. You won't have access to them necessarily, but it's just there in the distance to round out the town, give it lots more buildings, and that's why we're kind of knocking down the stuff in the distance. We'll be doing all this during the next build, which will assumedly be part of the barnyard pack. So I need to get that when that comes out, and we can hopefully build some cool stuff with the barnyard pack. I'm thinking chickens to start, because I think they make sense. It's going to be chickens or pigs. Basically, we're going to build like a little park area here on the right hand side. Initially, it was going to be part of this build, the idea being that the bear has come across from the park, come across from the forest on the right hand side, and kind of like broken through the chain link fence and got into the dumpster area. But the build was already huge, so you know, there's only so much I can justify, so I'll figure out a way to integrate the park with some barnyard animals. And that's what we'll be doing next time around. We're going to keep focusing on the town, because I really want to get this town built. I think it's going to look really cool when it's done. And it's probably the biggest project I've ever done in Planet Zoo, so we must give it all our love and attention. So this is just a little turn-off to the car parking area. I'm not going to pretend the roads. I did some research on some road signs for some bits. It's not going to be the most painfully accurate kind of thing. I was getting really annoyed here, but in daytime, that the concrete, you can see each individual square. You can only see it in like very specific times of day, but I don't know why it's a thing. It looks silly. Change it. Change it. It hurts me. But anyway, yeah, this is our diner, so it's gonna have like a staggered main building. It's a little bit too big. I wish I'd made this smaller by one block. Just one block smaller would have been enough for me to be happy. It's kind of the same story with the entire town. Everything is a little bit too big. You know, if the roads were one block smaller, I think they'd be a lot better. Most of the pathways, just everything should be one grid space smaller than it is, and I'd be happier with the entire build. But we are far too far gone to go make any changes like that. So not much we can do about that now. Anyways, the building has like a quite a boring side to it. And then it's got a sort of, you know, it's kind of like an all-American diner, 60s sort of aesthetic, you know, where you'd go get a milkshake. You'd pick up your favorite gal and you'd go get a milkshake in your convertible. That kind of vibe. So there's a sort of awning, I guess you'd call it. I don't know what you'd call it. This overhang that kind of sits at the front and then wraps around the side of the building that we're going to coat in neon. The neon, you'll see, gave me some problems. I think I've largely managed to fix it, but I think that should show up during the video. We'll have to see. But I just wanted to get some metal on there, and we'll start covering this in some LED tubes, which I searched for neon for ages. I was really confused. Like, where's my neon? It's called LED tubes. Of course, from the... what pack was this? It was the first European pack, right? Yeah, it was the European pack, the one with... where we built Amsterdam, of course, which I think is still like a really good build, actually. Maybe we can use some of the buildings from that as well, but we'll see. But yeah, just working on this. Doubling up on the neon there. And then we're going to use this kind of baby blue and this kind of sort of pinkish kind of colour, because it's, again, very 60s in that colour scheme. Very chill. The building is not going to be, so you can see I'm sort of blocking off the back of the building here. The roof is also going to come down a lot. Like, the shell of the building is a lot bigger than the interior of the building, kind of like with the lodge, but I've done a lot more work on the interior this time around. I'm about to make my first mistake. So what I wanted to do here was build like a linoleum floor, you know, like a black and white plasticky tiley linoleum sort of floor. Again, very quintessential 60s. So just using these little squares, but this, again, because of the scale in part, because the building is just a little bit too big, the skirts are too small, so we're just going to make those a little bit bigger. Don't be afraid to scrap things, you know. If something doesn't work, just kill it. Just destroy it. It's fine. This isn't the this is the anti-work subreddit. Just destroy it if it doesn't work, and, you know, don't commit to a bad idea. And that turned out pretty well. Again, I wanted a little, we talked about this, a lodge. I want a little rise on it. You know, it's nice to have a little staircase to enter a building. And then this was the challenge. I really wanted to do like a full-on neon sign for the Odia Diner, and I just, yeah, I didn't really know how else to do this. You know, using an in-game font wasn't going to work, so what I did was I made, you know, these are several separate screen panels, made the logo, well, I didn't make the logo, stole the logo, and then moved that over in Photoshop, and then what we'll do is we'll kind of trace the lettering using the LED tubes. I need to sneeze, so enjoy watching me for a second. I think it's faded. I woke up very sniffly today. I finished this build on Wednesday? Tuesday, maybe? I don't know. I did 14 hours or whatever on Planet Zoo in about 3 days. It's crazy. I've just really felt it, because I really like messing around the neon. I didn't realize it was going to cause me quite so many problems, as we'll see in a little bit. But yeah, this was never going to be 100% accurate, but I just wanted to get something that felt akin to the Odia Diner sign, and that would work from a distance, basically. So, you know, some of the corners are also going to be a little bit sharper. There's not much I can do about that. Although I came up with a solution, which, you know, ended up being my major problem, as we'll see in just a second. But I think this is the best way to do this, realistically. I can't think of a better way to make a sign like this in the game, at the very least. And in the end, I think it worked out really well. And also, Diner has a lovely little coincidence in its letters for a slightly horror film-themed park, which maybe you'll be able to figure out, but again, you'll see in just a moment as well. So at this point, it's kind of working, but obviously, I mean, that's a little bit shanky, to say the least. But that's, you know, it's always going to be the case. But this is getting smaller and smaller. You know, the letters get smaller. This is the smallest piece of LED tubing at 0.5 meters, and it's still quite large. So it gets quite difficult to do these very, very small bits. So what I realized here, and you're just seeing me do it there, is that if I rotate the LED tube so it's facing the other way, I get just like a little bright LED circle. And if I then duplicate those circles many times, as you can see, we can kind of do more, we've kind of got more control over our shapes. You know, we can do more intricate little bits, like this little corner here, we can make that curved, this corner here, we can make that curved, stuff like that. Now, that might be all well and good, and it works really, really well. The problem is the game cannot handle too many lights. Like, as soon as you get to too many lights, the game starts to really freak out. I don't know when I'm first going to notice it. Probably not until I finish the sign, but I'm going to do some more LED signing on the inside. It's okay for now. But there's just too many LED lights. There's nothing else to it. There's too many LED lights. And it was causing... You can kind of see it there on the right-hand side a little bit. You see all those little squares popping up, like flashing on the screen underneath the Dynatext. You can see it now. There you go, those sort of black squares. I didn't even notice at the time, really. Already causing problems. And that's not going to get any better. It got worse and worse and worse. And I spent a lot of time battling with the game and Googling to see if there's a way to figure it out. It's just because there's so many light sources competing. The game just can't handle it. And I tried to come up with a solution, and I did get there eventually, but took a little bit of finagling. But you can see that already it doesn't look great. Lots of blocky sort of effects. Considered having black shapes behind the text, and then kind of the thought made me sad of having to go through this, quite frankly. It was just, oh, it's going to be ridiculous. And also from the side, it was going to look terrible. So I'm going to start doing this for a little while, then quickly scrap the idea. I think it would have looked cool, but also not necessary. The problem I had at this point was that the concrete, which is kind of the correct color, inverted commas, you know, behind the neon lettering, is just too bright. So the neon doesn't really shine against it. You know, it kind of just, it's just washing it out with light at this point in time. It doesn't look great. This still, I don't know why I scrapped this. This looks good. This must be, it's because of that, I think, because I don't know how I was going to hide that. Oh, look at that. Anyways, yeah, so that was my first solution. I wanted to turn off some of the lights. So a couple of the lights on the diner have died. It's not the Odia diner, it's the Odia die. Eh? You know? Eh? Okay, like, it's a bit of a cliche. You see things when, you know, like, someone will take a photo of a shop sign where a couple of the letters have fallen off, so it spells something stupid, you know, or, like, kind of insults the company or something like that. It's kind of the same idea. This one, the N and the R have died, so it's the Odia die instead, which I... amused me far too much. I was very happy because I didn't plan that, and that's not part of the actual thing. That was just a happy coincidence. Anyways, I decided to just darken up the concrete behind it. It doesn't look as good in the daytime. This is very much a nighttime build. It doesn't look as good in the daytime, but it does make it dark enough that you can properly see the neon lettering and stuff like that, which is really the priority. Just building a bit of a holding thing here, just something that holds the lettering up. And other than the flashing, I was really happy with how it looked. I think it looks really good. But the flashing is problematic. I will fix it a little bit later on in the video. It took me a while to figure out how to fix it. I mean, in retrospect, how to fix it is fairly obvious. If the problem is too many lights, how do you fix it? You have less lights. But at this point, it looks worse than it did to me. Because you've got to remember, this is 1000% speed, this video. So the flashing looks insane, but from my perspective, it wasn't nearly as bad, you know. But it's gonna get worse and worse as we add more lighting. So next up, we're gonna throw in the basics of there's like a little billboard outside it. One of the big challenges for this diner, really, because it's, you know, it's neon lit and it's got the sort of black front and this weird shape, and it's a very different looking building than everything done so far. Actually, all four buildings are quite disparate, I would suggest, in terms of their sort of style. But this one, tonally, is way different than everything we've done before. So a big part of the challenge was just making the diner fit in to the wider town, to make it feel like part of the town itself, rather than this weird sticking out thing. The main way to do that is to throw in trees and, you know, just things that the other buildings have as well, and kind of blend it in like that. Yeah, just trying to do a bit of backing for the billboard. I've talked about this in a few videos now, about the billboard posters in this game and how they, you know, don't work from my perspective. But someone very helpfully on Twitter, and I think it was just Goron, they said, who originally found it out, showed me how the billboard posters work. So they do actually work. It's just not it's not an obvious way that they work, and it's not explained anywhere in the game, so I don't know why it's the way it is. I don't know why Frontier haven't explained how they function, because it's not logical. But I'll explain that probably a little bit later on in the video for those who are curious. And I know people are, because I googled it, and there was a Reddit post from within the last couple of weeks, people talking about these are still broken, right? Why has nobody fixed these these billboard posters, but they do actually function 100% correctly. It's just they're just stupid, basically. Alas. So this is the supporting cables. I don't know, every building I see with these kind of like little side structures has these hanging around it. So these just kind of sit around the side there to help hold up the... Because there's no column underneath the I don't know what you call it, awning. No column under a neon awning, so we stick these on, and these are very tough cables helping to support the entire structure. You'll notice as I'm doing this that I kind of just... I talk about this a lot, but it remains very true that I don't really have any rhyme or reason to what I'm building. I don't sit and think, okay, I have to do the roof now, and then I have to do the windows now, and then I have to do the billboard now, and kind of like work that bit until it's done. I kind of just get a little flash of inspiration, and I'll jump over there. And a little flash of inspiration, I'll jump over there. And I think it's a better way to work. I think if you let yourself get too preoccupied with trying to get one specific area done, you can hamper your ability to do anything, really, because, you know, if you're finding a little area frustrating, moving on and doing something else will help in that you'll... your mind will kind of tick over in the background and you'll think of new things. You know, there's no point in forcing yourself to do something that isn't going well. Just leave it for a little bit and maybe you'll get a different idea. Maybe another part of your build will then be able to inform that part of the build. You know what I mean? What am I doing here? Oh yeah, I just wanted a little underneath bit. I thought it looked really good. I was really happy with this one. This was like my favorite thing for a long time, this little overhang kind of thing. I think it's got really got that diner slash sort of retro cinema kind of vibe. But as I say, we are doing an interior to the building, so we need big old windows. God, I wish I'd made it one block smaller though. I really, really like how the building turns out inside, but it's just a little too thick. We've all been there, eh, folks? We've all been there. I'm not going to say the word edging at all in this video, okay? Not once, other than that one time. I will not say it again. After seeing last video and a few comments, I think I'm going to resist for this one. 17 minutes in. Do other people do this? Like, I'm just sitting here going to talk for an hour and 10 minutes. Do other people do this or not? I feel like... I kind of want you to see the entire building process. I set myself a hard limit that I don't render these videos at above 1000% speed. Because I think that's kind of the maximum before things start to get a little bit harder to interpret, I suppose. And the point is to let you see my building process. I don't know. You don't need to watch the entire video in one go, right? You can kind of like watch a little bit, watch the first half hour, come back later, that kind of jazz. Planet Zoo is no longer one of my heavy hitters, but I know there's people out there who love it, and I've really enjoyed playing it this week. So, you know, when that happens, I'm just going to do it, and we'll see what happens, I suppose. Looking forward to the Barnyard Pack. Well, ironically, I know some people are a little disappointed by it, but I don't know if they should be. And at the end of the day, there is more DLC coming, already confirmed via the Frontier Unlocked stream. So there is more to come. People don't need to panic in that regard. I guess if the Barnyard Pack had been the final DLC, I could understand a little bit of reticence in that regard then, because that it would maybe be a little anticlimactic for a final DLC. Yeah. Just doing a little bit of... bordering, you know, around the building, just a little bit of intrigue. I say this all the time, but you can't have your building walls just kind of sit flush with the floor. It never looks good. If you've got a building, just stick like a little bit of stone, stick a little bit of wood, stick a little bit of brick in this case, and just do something to sort of break the gap or the flushness between the... I need to put maybe like a gutter down there. The flushness between the wall and the floor. And makes your buildings just feel a lot more realistic. What am I doing? Right, so windows. We've got five windows in the side of each... Well, in each side. And these need window frames and need window sills and yada yada yada. I was trying to make this all fairly accurate to the real thing. It ended up looking... fairly disparate, I suppose. Fairly different, especially the car park and stuff like that. It's nothing to do with Alan Wake. That's completely separate and that's just made up. But a lot of these design elements were obviously taken from the actual Odia Diner. I kind of wish I changed the name to the, like... I mean, the Odia Diner is a great pun, but we don't have Deer Fest, we've got Fish Fest. So it would have been, you know, the Fishy Diner or something, or... Yeah, it doesn't really work as well. The Odia Diner is a great pun. Well, it would have been nice to come up with a fish equivalent. And you'll see this regularly throughout the video. Kind of do a little bit and then kind of, oh, but no, I want to work on the car park for a little bit. Let's go move some blocks around. The car park, shape-wise, really wasn't finalized until very near the end of the video. So there was a lot of just building things and seeing how they feel and then coming back to them a little bit later on. New ideas, like this wasn't originally part of the plan at all, but I thought, well, I want this to feel like a real place that, you know, there's no point in building a building with interiors, etc., if I'm not going to put the effort in to make it feel like a real building. So this is meant to be like a loading bay sort of shebang. A loading Michael. So there'll be like a bit of a ramp up here and a little parking spot, which is reserved for, you know, vans and trucks. This little parking spot here on the right-hand side that you can just see here is reserved for your larger vehicles, for your delivery vehicles, because the diner is going to need deliveries, right, of coffee, of food, etc., etc. So I just figured that's a nice normal thing to put in. I don't usually care about this kind of, you know, the things that feel like real things. It's just not usually my vibe, but I don't know why I've been it's just been vibing with me lately. I haven't built something stupid in ages. I mean, we did build a mystical, magical, religious cult well in the last video, so I'm not going to worry too much about it, but it's a little bit of a thing. This build has no horror elements in it whatsoever. Zero. It's very disconcerting. They can't all have horror elements, so they do lose a bit of that oomph, you know, a bit of that individuality, but that is not allowed to keep going forever, so I don't know how the chickens or the pigs or whatever I do in the next one is going to have those horror elements, but I'm going to have to find some to integrate. I need to develop the story of the town a little bit further, so I need to just come up with some ideas. So this is a little no parking section, basically just a cube with some diagonal lines. This is a fairly typical what a no parking section looks like in reality, you know, this kind of shaping with the lines and stuff like that, this sort of diamond, I guess, with the strokes for the middle, and just says you're not allowed to park here. I had to try to breathe for a second there. Wanted to do a little no parking sign. It's nice to use the in-game signs every now and again, but we lack variety on the in-game signs. We don't really have that many of them, so you know, it's much easier to use like little things like this and just grab a sign from, you know, either make a sign in Photoshop or grab a sign from the internet. We've used about 7 or 8 different signs in this build, actually. There's quite a lot of them. None of the billboard posters yet, because I finished the build before I found out how the billboard posters work. Here, what I wanted was a neon sign hanging up on the wall. I know I successfully do it, but I can't remember how. Am I just going to use the LED tubes? I think so. I was trying to figure out like a different way, because it feels like, because this text is so small, that maybe it wasn't going to work, the LED tubes, and I thought, oh, maybe we'll do it that way, but that's going to be a disaster. I think there's this fantastic font that someone's made, which I didn't end up using, but was a consideration. I think that text was too small was the problem, so I decided to use a bigger font, make the sign bigger than I originally planned, but by doing that, I could then, I could do this. I could kind of make an LED neon tube sign for my neon open sign. This is where things began to get a little bit ropey, though, because there's just too much neon. Wait, no, I didn't end up using this. It's too big. It's too big. The problem is it's too big. What did I end up doing? I think I ended up using a Planet Zoo sign. But yeah, I tried. I really liked that, but I just couldn't find a way to make it work. And sometimes that's important as well. Sometimes it's important to realize what isn't working and scrap it, you know? So I ended up using an actual Planet Zoo sign, and what you can do with these, you'll see me do it in a second as a bit of a tester, but if you've got a sign like this one here, if you can see it there where the text is sitting on the corrugated, we don't use this, this looks stupid, but if you move a sign, there's a single pixel space where what you can do is the text kind of sticks out a little bit from the sign itself, so you can kind of like embed the font into something. I think it ended up looking really good. Scrap the wood around the side, cover that in, you know, LED, and then the text itself is obviously very bright and shiny, so I think it ended up working out really well, actually. Doesn't look so great from behind, but, well, none of us do, but I still don't really know how to fix that, frankly, so, you know, I'm not going to. But some open signs in the windows, luring the punters from a distance, and then obviously you've got these big wooden blocks standing in your windows, but again, don't really know how I would fix that personally, so now what are we doing? This is the one problem with this building style is that when it comes to doing these videos, I'm like, I have to wait to see. Like, I know what I've done in the build, but I don't know what order I did it because it was nonsensical. So now I have to wait and see what I'm doing next. So it's time to do a little bit of the interior, which has this kind of dark. The outside's very neon and 60s modern, I guess. The inside is much more classical in some ways. It's kind of got that same vibe, but it's much more yellows and browns. It's much sort of cozier interior wise. I think it's a really nice contrast, actually. If you go look at pictures of the ODU Diner online, you'll see the interior is always rendered very warm, very cozy with sort of dappled sunlight moving in and stuff like that. But just trying to figure out how I was going to do the windows here. Using different types of wood to inlay those, and ended up moving. I wanted the windows to be inlaid into the wood, so we'll end up moving those as well in just a moment. The wood wall, the wood paneling above it needs pulling out a little bit, so it kind of sits over the top of the windows, and the windows look that like they're embedded into the walls a little bit. You know, the way a real window would be. That's why I'm kind of layering up the wood here. inside's very shadowed, so I kind of nip outside every now and again to check the colour of what I'm making. Oh, excuse me, I've woke up very sniffly today. I'm about like 4 hours sleep or something. Bloody Nora. Okay, I have to talk so much, I don't get a break. This is why people don't do this. It's not easy to talk for an hour and 10 minutes, non-stop. We're only halfway through. Not even halfway through. But yeah, just layering up the wood around the outside. Doing that on both sides. It was a little... I didn't really realise until I threw it around the other side. It was a little bit more orange and a little bit harsher in saturation than I originally intended. If I do have one problem with this building in the end, you can see there, I'm just pulling them. pulling the wood out. For God's sake. So that it, like I said, so it sits over the rim of the window at least a little bit. The lighting is like, it's very dark inside of the diner. And there's not really much I can do about the lighting where we are in this town is really awkward. I wish I'd built the town facing another direction because the sun never hits the front of the buildings. It absolutely refuses. It makes no sense to me, the sun position in this game. I'm not going to pretend otherwise, but it just absolutely refuses to hit the front of the buildings. And it makes them feel a little washed out in daytime, which is a bit of a shame. Anywho, wood paneling. The ones at the side, you can see, have had a different change of direction. And then, let's work on the car park a little bit. If you see like a very sudden jump like that, it's probably because I've stopped recording and gone and done something else and come back. This video, as I say, I did this in about 3 or 4 days, all 13, 14 hours, whatever it was. But I did it in, I think it was 12 videos. You know, some of them were only 20 minutes long, some of them were more like 2 hours. It was very... I've got a little bit of spare time, something else is happening, I'm waiting for something else, yada yada yada, let's go and hop on Planet Zoo and get a little bit of work done, you know? I should say, for the barnyard pack, don't expect a build super soon. Hopefully next week, hopefully the week it comes out. We'll see what happens next week, but it's not going to be like a first couple days kind of shebang. I just don't have the time to do that kind of thing again, I don't think. Do I? No, there's other things I have to do. Like, I shouldn't have been playing Planet Zoo this much this week, frankly. I should have been doing other things with my week, but I just... As soon as I built this diner, as soon as I started to like it, and as soon as the interior in particular started to work a little bit, I was like, well... I don't know, screw every other responsibility I have. Let's do Planet Zoo. Like, back in the old days, when Planet Zoo first came out, I used to just play it for about 12 hours a day, every single day. It's crazy. But it was necessary. To get the builds out, you know. Anywho, done the car park, apparently. just back inside, just trying to make the interior windows feel a little bit more interesting. I don't want the yellow to necessarily show from the outside. Also moving the neon signs indoors a little bit. It's kind of, weirdly enough, in my head, I don't have many references for this kind of thing, because you don't get that many neon signs over here. The reference in my head was Always Sunny in Philadelphia, where they've got the closed sign that Charlie turns off and on, and he thinks a cause sign, and he needs to be able to obviously turn it on and off from the inside, right? So you would hang up your neon signs, but they would shine through the window. They wouldn't be on the other side of the window. Doing a little bit of architrave? Coving or architrave? I can't remember. Well, I'm going to Google this. I think it's architrave. No, it's coving. There's only columns. Okay, we're talking coving. Coving around the bottom of the floor. Again, don't like walls and floors to connect directly. It's a real bugbear for me. I really prefer them to be separate. So, just using this mustardy, orange, warm mustard colour, I guess you'd call it. This warm mustard colour to do that. And then I'm going to hang up the neon. I don't want the neon signs to just be sort of stuck to the wall because that doesn't make much sense. It's just building like a little hanging mechanism kind of thingamajiggy. Just a couple little cables here, not a big deal. In order to make it just look a tad more realistic. I see me there messing with the camera stuff. The game was, I don't know if it's because I'm playing so much or because there's so much stuff in the area, but the game was really putting up a fire with me quite a lot during this build. Like, just little things would complete. Like the X button that you press, you know, continuously on this game for detailed movement like that kept, just stopped working. You know, it hated me. The van, of course, I didn't make. We've seen the van before. We used it in one of our previous builds. Again, all those people will be credited a little bit later on. Now, for the interior to start, I was a little apprehensive about this. And this was hard work, this bit. But basically, there's this curved diner station kind of thing. So the staff members sit on the inside. Oh, this is just because obviously we've got horizontal bars and vertical bars. Because that's how the panels work. I just put a little bar splitting them in two so it feels a little bit more like purposeful, basically. Anyways, yeah, so there's this sort of diner thing in the middle, and you sit around that in a sort of semicircle, well, this kind of weird little penis shape, and it's got this flat top bar sort of area in this color, and this was a pain in the ass to say that this was annoying. Yeah, problem one that I made here is I've used the stone circle bits for the bottom, and the straight stone pieces aren't flat for this same sort of building set. They've got like little ridges on them. So I sorted a wood one, and the wood one, as you can see on the left there, is just a slightly different color. It's not the right color. So I'm doing all this work, not realizing that somehow, and I'm gonna have to kill all this in a second and swap the stone pieces to wooden pieces, because you just can't make it the same. Yeah, I'm trying here, but it's just not gonna happen. So I had to scrap the stone and turn it into wood and try again. Having learned since last time, more importantly. But yeah, this was important. This is the sort of the central piece, you know, this is the main thing in this room. This is the thing that dominates the room, and it's the hub that everyone gathers around. So it was important to get it right as much as I could. I don't really build this kind of thing very often at all. Those of you who've seen the channel, you'll know I don't build buildings. You know, I don't really tend to enjoy it. But I think it's mainly, it's not that I don't enjoy building buildings. It's just I don't feel like I'm very good at it. That's not me being harsh on myself, because I think this build ends up really good. But obviously, this is crimping from a real thing. Well, from a different video game. I don't really have the ability to like come up with architecture and building designs on my own. It is a gap in my ability, and that's okay. It's okay. We don't have to be perfect at everything, you know? Do we? But so that's fine. It's something I'd like to get better at. And I figure the more buildings I make, even if I'm crimping on other people's styles, I will get better at it over time by just learning how these buildings are put together, yada, yada, yada. But the actual building of it, I didn't dislike. I really enjoyed doing this. This was quite fun. Trying to come up with ways to make these shapes work, which can be really difficult. Like, building just this required quite a lot of thinking. It's not perfect. You see the wood overlay there at the front. It's a bit awkward, but just coming up with this was difficult. And likewise this. So there's like a metal foot, almost, I guess, going around the base of the bar area. So it's kind of used some, I think it's opaque glass I ended up using for that. And a little bit of a lip on that as well. Little lips are the top tip for buildings, is a little lip, unironically. I really feel like it's a big deal in terms of making things feel real. There's also another bar, you know, kind of like where you put your feet up, because there's going to be stools around the outside, so you sit on your stool and you put your feet up on the metal bar, and I just couldn't. I'm going to try here, and I just couldn't get this to work. What I should have done, really, I kind of gave up on it. I should have used the smallest rod, the 0.5. I think there's a 0.5 rod, or whatever the smallest rod is, and just kind of gone around the circle manually with little bits of rod, basically. Rod, if you're watching this, I'm very sorry. But I tried to use the curves, and because they're not the same curve as the bar, it just looked awkward, and you can see it's all misshapen there. It didn't look any good, so I ended up doing this and then scrapping it. Because again, it's important to know. It's funny because I talk a lot about how things look bad at first, but you got to be persistent, right? Because, you know, they're not always going to look bad. You need to stick with it, keep being persistent, and eventually you'll end up somewhere good. But it's also, you've also got to know when things don't work. There's my little person. So this is a handy thing that I think everyone should do. Just have a workshop item. Because especially, I don't want to build with guests knocking around in an area like this. Guests can't even get here, right? There's no way for guests to get here. So it's really handy to have like a little workshop item that's the same size as a guest, because then what you can do is kind of just plop them in like this and you've got something for scale. I think they usually have a head, so they'd be a little bit taller than this. Usually they have a head. Not all the time. This is a rug. This is one thing I'd really like in this game, actually. It would be really useful. It's a rug sort of texture, you know, like for the ground texture that we have, or the building shapes for the floor, at least. But just like a rug sort of texture. But you know what? It's not really a rug. It's kind of like one of those, it kind of protects the floor. It's kind of plasticky fabric, I guess you'd call it. I don't know what the term is. I don't know what the actual name of it is, but it's a plasticky sort of fabric. You'd have it in a place like this to keep the floor protected and to dry feet a little bit and stuff like that. And I've got to say, concrete surprisingly works really well. I was thinking this was going to be a disaster, but I put that down. I thought, okay, that looks pretty cool, actually. Next we need, you know, we are halfway through this video. Madness. If you want a break, this would be a good time. I want a break. We need stools. Stools. I really wanted to build as much, like, there's plenty of stools on the workshop, right? But whilst I wasn't going to go build all the vehicles, because I'm not, you know, clinically insane, I really wanted to build as many of the things as possible. I really wanted to have as much control as possible as well, which meant a lot of figuring, like, building things in this game is really just about sticking things together to figure out what's going to work, essentially. So kind of got the shape of the stool, but obviously the top looks a bit stupid, and you can see me scrolling down here and flicking through different things and throwing different things on, just trying to find something that will work as a stool. It ended up being these primitive spheroid oblates, what are they calling it, oblates, which all were in the same color, and I'm gonna finagle those sides out a little bit in a second, neaten it all up, but ended up working all right. Actually, ends up forming a pretty believable little stool sort of shape. It was very, very difficult. You can see I'm trying to grab the bits and proving to be very difficult, but just move it all inwards, and it's got that kind of, I wanted it to feel, you know, it's got that soft and pillowy, fluffy, not fluffy, soft, pillowy, rounded kind of look, which is very much what I was going for. So they'll sit around the side of the bar. Again, everything feels a little bit too big because the building's a little bit too big. The bar in particular, I think, could do being just a bit smaller, but alas, a bit more carpet at the side, rug, plastic, whatever the heck you want to call it. But again, really impressed by how well it works. I really am. And then came, this was a tricky portion. So the game has these really cool restaurant booths. As you can see, they're really well designed. And it drives me insane that we've got these lovely cushion textures and cushion items in the game, but they're not a separate item. They're only here in the restaurant booth item. And they're just too small. They just don't fit the scale of my building. Look at the size of the windows. You know, and I wanted the booths to sit all the way along these walls near enough. So yeah, I initially tried to do this, like, kind of, I don't know why I'm using aircon units for this, frankly. Just trying to sort of fill the gap in the middle, and then I can put the booths on either side, and hopefully, you know, I can use them, because they look great. They're really well designed, but they're just too small. And there was an acceptance now, basically, that I couldn't cheat and I had to make my own. I even went online, I went onto the workshop and I had a look at, plenty of people have posted diners online on the workshop, but everyone uses these booths. So it was a little sad realizing that I was not going to be able to do the same thing because of the scale. I had to make my own, basically. It's not like we could scale down the building at this point in time, right? So there was a lot of going through all the different material items in the game. I turn on flexicolor, as you can see, because I need to be able to... I need that. That's the only capability I know I need, is flexible coloring. And I just start moving along and picking out various items that I thought maybe could turn into a booth, basically. There was no specific item in mind. It was, will this function? Will this work? And most of what you're seeing here will get scrapped, but it was a good starting point. You can see that the basic shape is there pretty nicely already. The size is basically spot on. I'm just using this... I mean, it says it's a temple support beam, but because it's got this slightly grainy texture to it, you could see it being, you know, that kind of like slightly rough leather that you tend to have in sort of older buildings like this, older cafes and stuff like that. You could, it tracked, you know, that. I wasn't unhappy with this already. I would have been okay with this as is, but I started to mess around with other things. So using these India fascia pillar thingamajiggies, just kind of moving these along horizontally until they form sort of a nice wider curve. And you see already there it's looking more like a seat cushion because it's got a little bit of curve to it. And then I start to duplicate that and thought, okay, well, this makes more sense, basically. And then it was a case of trying to find something for that to sit around. And initially I thought, okay, we'll use more of the fascia. That looks great. What I didn't realize was, of course, that it's poking outside the building. The other half of this is way out of the wall on the other side. I will realize in a minute. There it is. So the cushion I was happy with, but it was a case of finding something to support. The cushion can't just float. It's not a goat cushion. A goat? It's not a ghost cushion. It's a real cushion. So it can't just float. So I just started layering up this. This Indonesian timber has saved this build in so many ways. I've used it many, many times. It's got a lovely wooden texture to it. It's really good with colour. Just kind of made like a little box for the seats to sit in. And ended up pretty happy with it, actually. It's a little bit dark, actually, looking at it now. I might brighten those seats up a little bit. But, yeah, had the right kind of vibe. And it was a bit of a nightmare to get there. But, yeah, sometimes you have to do that. Sometimes I really nearly stuck with the restaurant ones, but I knew it wasn't going to look right. I knew they were too small. These are about a third bigger, 30 to 40% bigger, I would suggest. I just knew it wasn't going to look good, so... Keep hammering away, try different items until it works out. This is... Yeah, and you'll kind of know what I mean just looking at it. It's this kind of black, long, rectangular strips of plasticky, fabric-y kind of stuff where people wipe their feet or use it again to protect the ground from spills and stuff like that. You know what I mean? It's very common in this kind of place. I don't know. That's all the explanation we're going to have. The next challenge was the table. The first thing I tried was the aluminium, and then I tried a million other things and ended up going back to the aluminium. The problem was I wanted it to be metallic. I wanted it to have a bit of shine to it because, again, I feel it's kind of appropriate for a diner. Here, I grabbed that little bronze. I love that bronze color. I think it looks fantastic. I just grabbed it because I thought, well, bronze kind of suits atmospherically, but it's not gonna end up doing anything. But every now and again, like you see the dumpster thing, the skip in the background. Every now and again, I'll grab... If I'm scrolling down, let's say I'm trying to build a table, so I'm looking for appropriate table items, but I see something I like for something else. Just grab it, just throw it out, you know, stick it in the background, leave it for later. So the opaque plastic, I think, looks really good from above. I think the texture and colour is fantastic, perfect for the table, but it's just too thick, and you've got to think about how people are going to get onto their seats, and then... You know, how are they going to get their legs under, basically? So just ended up using slabs of aluminium. But then because you can't overlay aluminium without it flickering crazily, as you can, it's hard to see in the video, but it's flickering automatically, bah, 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 just like that. So I figured we'll do like a wooden inlay over the top of the aluminium. And that'll kind of cover all of that up. And I think I ended up using a different, that wood had just a little bit too much texture for me. Ended up using, again, my beloved Indonesian stained timber, which has been the MVP of this build for me. Just inlay that a little bit into the table, and there you go. Got lovely diner tables. We've got the aluminium, which I wanted. Also got the wood, which matches with everything else, and looked pretty good. You'll see that I've got the ceiling here, so it's on its own. Also, this is when I realized that the the Australian signs I use for the stools, they glow. I feel like I've had that realization in the past, but they glow in perpetuity. You can't turn them off, so they will always glow. I think it actually looks pretty cool, but it was a bit of a surprise at the time. But you'll see what I do is I don't want the ceiling on the building for obvious reasons, because I'm trying to build the interior, and if you've got a ceiling in the way, it'll be, you know, in the way, basically. So I have that floating above the building, and this every now and again I lower it down just so I can get a feeling for what the building is going to look like when the ceiling's on, and so I can space things out as appropriate and stuff like that. And this is meant to be the door to the bathrooms. It isn't, because I don't want to build bathrooms. You're just not allowed to go down there, frankly. I just won't put a path in. But yeah, just having a door that goes off to somewhere makes it feel more realistic, basically. And it doesn't matter if it's a door to nothing. It's actually a door to a bear, as you'll see later on, but it's the bear door. It looks like a bathroom door. It's not. It's a bear door. And if you don't realize that, that's on you. So the other part of the bar is that it doesn't flow. It sticks to the ceiling. So it's kind of like a two-tier kind of thing. It's got a bit of a retro futuristic kind of vibe in terms of the shapes and the colors, I would say. It feels very much like it's kind of like an airport in the 60s almost. And this also has like a wooden lip. Now this actually in reality has this, the actual piece has this really nice curve to it. It's kind of like slinks in from the outside inwards, but I just could not think of a viable way to do that. So at least not a viable way that wouldn't take a gajillion hours. And the build was already taking a gajillion hours. So it's just I think I'm about to realize that this doesn't work. I can't have that interior. I can't remember why. You need to be able to see the ceiling between the circle, so I can't use flat pieces for the outline. I want like a bit of a lip, so the big wooden bit sticks to the ceiling and then there's a lip of wood around it, right? A lip of wood, strange sentence, but that was what I was going for. But I can't use the flat pieces because you need to be able to see the ceiling on the middle. Does that make sense? You following me? Hopefully. And then I'm doing something. Why am I doing this? I actually don't know. I'll figure it out. Why am I doing this? I actually don't know. Like, looking at what I'm doing here, I don't logically see a reason for it to exist. Oh, right, yes. So I wanted the bottom to have like a bit of a lip, wooden lip as well, matching the bar on the lower side. So you just build it on top and then move it to the bottom. That's why I was confused. Right, okay, that makes sense. Again, lowering the ceiling to kind of get a feeling for where that's going to be, putting in some of the coving detailing around the outside of that as well. Just again, so this is like a good way to also keep in mind where your ceiling is going to be in the future as well. Like, yeah, I've got this little detail here, so every time I move the ceiling down next time, I kind of know exactly where it is I'm trying to put it. Big old piece of wood. I'm going to put it in the right place. I had to make one joke. It's not even a good joke. There's no animals, man. What else have I meant to joke about other than wood? The entire building is made from wood. Now, what I did realize eventually was that I don't want the ceiling to be made out of wood, so that's what we're doing here. We're kind of just trying to search for an alternate texture. There's too much of this stained timber. It looks great, but there's a little bit too much of it. It's a little bit too homogenous. So I ended up using concrete instead. Yeah, the concrete in this game, because it's colour changeable and it changes colour really nicely. Some things in this game do not change colour well. They just look a bit weird. But this changes it really nicely, so it's really useful for lots of different textures. You know, it just looks like a rough sort of texture. So you can use it for fabric, you can use it for mud, you can use it for concrete, obviously. Use it for metal in some circumstances. And I couldn't really get a good image of it, but I know that the real... Well, not the real, but the Odiadyna in Alan Wake has this kind of grid on the ceiling, this sort of metal grid built into the ceiling. Now, I think the purpose of that, and someone feel free to tell me because I don't know for sure, but I believe the purpose of that is so you can hang lights and fans and stuff like that, and they've got like a bit more of a solid texture to stick into, kind of. It just makes the ceiling look more interesting, if nothing else, this kind of like soft grid kind of built into that. So, right, with that done, going to build, I just like want a little menu, you know, hanging up here at the front, using the TVs here, but of course the billboard posters, which at this point I did not know how they worked. I still haven't used them myself. I'm still a little bit anxious about that, but I think I can probably make it happen. but I hadn't used them yet. They've got a lovely texture to them. They really do. And actually, now that I think about this, so I've got some signs. You see that window in the back left on the left-hand side now? That's meant to be like a kitchen, basically, you know, like a serving station kind of thing from the kitchen to the main part of the diner. This is me trying to sort out the flashing, changing all my settings just desperately because it was really annoying me. Look at it going crazy because we've had the neon signs at the side. It's just gone bonkers, absolutely bonkers. And I kept trying to fix it, but there's no setting I could do that would fix it. And because, as you can see, so when I start adding lights on the interior, especially at a distance, they go even crazier and it just looks terrible. Looks really, really bad. So change had to be made, and change was made, but change was made later. Some hanging bulb kind of things here. Just these are going to sit sort of around the bar, light up the bar area for the punters. There's no like nice hanging lights like this in the game. You have to make your own, really. Excuse me. But yeah, so there's some, that back left area where the kitchen is, there's going to be some like advert signs there. But because I didn't know how the other things worked, I was using the screens rather than the billboard posters. And the problem with that is that the screens have like, they're really bright for one. They're very, very bright. You have to darken everything loads in Photoshop to make them work. And they're also a little bit reflective. They don't look like paper or anything. Now that I hopefully know how the billboard posters work, maybe I can go back. I'll probably go back before this video gets uploaded and before we do the walkthrough bit, and I'll make some changes to see if I can make them feel a little bit cooler. Make them blend in a little bit better. More of a naturalistic sort of texture. Less shiny, basically. But, and it'll be a good test to see if I do, in fact, know how the billboard posters work, if nothing else. Anywho. Some ceiling fans. First time I ever used a ceiling fan. Because there's all these things that I never use because I never do building interiors. So I got to use all this new stuff. For me, new stuff. Which is quite cool. And here, just finally adding, you know, the building does need a roof. Eventually. It's easy to get too focused on the interior. But go back in, just make a couple little changes. Add a ceiling to the building. 52 minutes in, folks. We are flying. I get quite a lot done in the next. I mean, this, so 52 minutes at 1000% speed. That's, yeah. This took a long time. This took nearly 10 hours, basically, just this so far. There's just so much finagling, so much trying to figure out what was going to work. So, in comparison, I get a lot done in the next 15 minutes or so of the video. Like, the entire exterior, like, we haven't even started the bear habitat, basically. It is just going to live in, like, a little trash section, but still. It's a trash man. Do a little bit of pavement side bit on the buildings. And the important thing, really, is trees, because the trees are going to hopefully bring the diner in a little bit so it feels... Oh, yeah, so this is where I said I lost some time. I lost about an hour. Really, all I did was throw in some shapes for the parking lot, you know, throwing like parking bits, lines, I guess, for vehicles to park in, as you can see on the left there, and downloaded a bunch of workshop items and threw those in. A bit of tree, a bit of rock work, a bit of the leaf litter, but I didn't do that much. It was a figuring things out hour more than anything else. I think I did the signage and stuff like that during that as well, but we'll see. Just a second. Didn't have a good grasp at this point in time of where the bear was actually going to go. So this is me trying to make a gap for it. So the idea is that there's a car park here. It's not a big car park. It would be much bigger in reality, but I don't want a huge car park because it's going to look stupid. And there's going to be like a trash section dumpster kind of thing behind the car park bit. These are just little bumpers to stop people, you know, crashing, usual kind of thing, I think. Just something, you have to have something in front of the vehicle. And nothing too square, so if they hit it, it's not the end of the world, but they can kind of roll over it, but it'll stop the vehicle, you know? And the idea was that there's going to be this long... It feels a bit weird having it behind the car park, you know, for the people who work in the diner, it's a bit of a trek across a car park to drop the bins off. And a lot of time here where I'm just got staring at the screen, it's me figuring out if there's an alternate way to do this, if there's somewhere else I could put it, but it would have required so much remodeling, it just wasn't realistic. So it's all going to sit sort of there in front of the cars. But the cool thing about that, the benefit, is the cars have headlights that throw out light, as a headlight is wont to do. So it kind of lights up the bear exhibit in a really cool way. It lights up all the dumpsters and that kind of stuff. So it wasn't ideal, but it kind of little bit of a happy accident. And another skill forward. So you can see I've done the science here. Just these are really easy to do. I'm sure people already know how to do this kind of thing in Photoshop or GIMP or whatever you use and bring it over into Planet Zoo. But if anyone needs an explanation, that's fair enough. I know you want to explain it very quickly. Let's say you want to build... You've got three screen panels width in a sign, right? A screen panel, the larger one, is 512 by 512. So all you do is you make a new Photoshop document that's 1,536 pixels in width and 512 pixels in height. You take whatever your final sign is, whatever you want it to look like, you stretch it to fit that document. And then you make another document that's 512 by 512. Copy and paste your original one over, and obviously it's only going to fill up only one third is going to fit inside it because it's now, you know, one third of the length, and you just save the first square, and then you shuffle it along, you save the second square, you shuffle it along, you save the third square, basically. I'm sure people know it, I just thought I'd mention it. Anywho, so, it works really well. And not much to add to it by that. We need more billboard sizes. We've got a 4 meters is the smallest, except there's also a 0.5 meters. If we could get like a 2 meter and a 1 meter billboard, that'd be really, really helpful, actually. There is the TV, but the TV is always shiny and also has like a little bit of a rim around it, so... Rim's okay. I can say rim. I can't say edge. Anyway, it's just throwing some vehicles around the town. I might have gone a little bit hard on this. I might need to... delete some of these, but I just wanted them, you know, a lot of them are sitting at the traffic lights, but some of them are sort of mid-turn, some of them are queued up behind each other. It's static, it kind of feels like a ghost town, but in a photo rather than a video, I wanted it to feel like the town was alive. You know, it's got tourists, it's got locals, it's got police investigating the deaths and stuff like that. You know, I wanted it to feel like there were people driving around the town and that it was a real active place, you know? This one's got one light lit on the left because he's indicating to go left. I should do. And yeah, it was getting there at this point. It was finally getting there. Decided to make the plant life a little bit more... Like, part of this town's always been this whole... And part of every single building I ever build in all of time and history is that nature is fighting back a little bit. You know, nature's encroaching. They haven't necessarily... They've kind of got their visage of keeping the town... sort of kept and nice looking, but yeah, there's cracks creeping through, you know? Oh, I want to try something here, so... Ah, sorry. Alexa, cancel timer. That's my alarm just in case, Jesus. Someone mentioned in the last video that I should turn on all the sandbox options to make my life easier. Just to confirm, I have all the sandbox options already on, like everything is on in terms of, you know, animal welfare and stuff like that. You still need staff building, so otherwise your animals don't have any... There's no way to drag and drop animals into the game. It would be fantastic if I could just plonk an animal in an exhibit and not have to have staff area at all. That would make my life a thousand times easier, but unfortunately that's not the case. I do have breakouts off, though. I was under the impression, so this is something I kind of learned. It's how I thought it worked originally. At least I think. I know I'm not making sense yet. Give me a second. But I thought... Even with breakouts off, animals can still walk out of null barriers. But null barriers do actually work, I believe. I say, well, maybe they don't. I'm not convinced that null barriers work to block animals in. I don't think they do. Anyways. which is fine for this build, as you'll see. I was already having thoughts here that I was slightly concerned how the bear was going to be contained. The bear kind of took care of that for me, again, as you'll see. But... yeah, I rotated the hours around there because I had two entrances into the parking lot and none of them were a dedicated exit, which makes no sense. And, oh, this is... So I did use workshop item. This fantastic... I don't know who made it. I should check. I'll let you know in the video. But this absolutely fantastic dumpster item by someone. Really, really cool. Really looks good. And I just wanted to... You know, I've been recording for so long at this point. Yeah, I'm not going to make everything myself. I think that's... a little bit silly of an expectation that I place on myself. I don't think anyone else places that expectation on me. I think I place it on myself sometimes. But yeah, they were absolutely fantastic. So really, really helpful. Look really, really cool. And I wanted these falling over. The idea, of course, the bear has been rummaging around, knocked over a few of the dumpsters and stuff like that. Also wanted this area to feel out of bounds. You know, you're not allowed down here. This is for the staff members in order to to sort out the trash. It's not for guests parking at all or anything like that. You know, you have to stay out of this area down here, basically. And for some trees in there, we're gonna get. I've done a lack of foliage work in this video because it's, you know, it's a building and a car park. How much foliage can you have? This was a good opportunity to make it feel a little bit rougher. The area directly next to this, like behind the dumpsters, so that right bit where the grass is now, is going to be a park sort of area. It's just a small park to split the gap between this area and the houses. So it makes sense here that nature's encroaching a little bit, you know, especially a dumpster area that's being maybe neglected a little bit as well. And I don't know if the arrows make any sense, but they make logical sense. Whether they're realistic is another kettle of fish, but they logically make sense. I just want to make sure I've got little trees popping up every now and again, because that's how we're going to tie in this very neon, very weird style diner with everything else going on in the town. And I was hoping here that null barriers would keep animals contained. Again, I'm pretty sure they don't. Even with breakouts off, I'm pretty sure null barriers don't. Well, maybe they do, though. I did Google this as part of the video, and someone on Reddit said they definitely do. I don't know what to think. Either way, for whatever reason, my bear doesn't move. I don't know if anyone has a solution to this, please let me know. But as you'll see, so I'm working on, like, we need a way to add the bear to the game, annoyingly. Oh, excuse me. But what I figured was, okay, I'll build like a little staff outpost thing kind of here on the right-hand side. And this can service both this habitat and also the park, right? So whilst I'm building something I didn't necessarily want to build quite yet, just punched my monitor, fantastic. It can be used for both exhibits. So it kind of works. And I figured, well, I'm not going to hide this one. I'm going to build like a little ranger outpost, and it's going to use the same design elements as the lodge. So you'll see I'm jumping across, back and forth, grabbing more bits from the log just to, from the lodge just to make sure that this little building also feels like it was. You know, this is by Elderwood. You know, the diner is obviously a private corporation, private individual, whatever. Whereas the lodge and this little building here are Elderwood designs, inverted commas. We might do another building later on that uses the same design elements again to kind of like hammer home that feeling that this is the sort of original Elderwood design philosophy, and this is what the local council likes to design their buildings like, because it feels appropriate for Elderwood, you know? Now, I mean, we are weirdly near the end. Time flies. The first half hour drags. I was like, this is long. How have I talked for this long already? And then the last half hour, I just, it's fine. Time was zipped by. What a joyous occasion. I think you folks aren't seeing this video for a couple days yet, but yeah, hopefully people have enjoyed it. Gives me a couple days to do a couple changes like that. I'm going to try to change those billboard posters inside. I don't think you see that in the video. I think I did that myself later on anyway. But anyway, all the little details, the benches, the hanging baskets, the text. So I just wanted this to say Ranger Station, I think it was. I watched a film fairly recently called Lovely, Dark and Deep, which sounds much weirder than it was in reality. It's a sort of a horror film kind of thing. With the woman from Barbarian, actually, she was really good in it. The film sucks, though. But she was like a ranger in a national park, and they had these little ranger huts that they stayed in off in the middle of nowhere. They didn't really look like this, but it's what I had in mind. I don't know why, considering it doesn't look like this, but still. Obviously, this area here on the right is going to be undone. There's going to be a big gap here. I'm not doing the park and stuff like that because that's very much part of the next build. So I think this build will feel more complete when we get our next animal in the next video. Like I said, originally it was going to be part of this video, but you know, I think I've done enough already at this point. So yeah, saving that for next time. Need a lot more stuff in our trash yard though. Things spilling out, things sort of filling up the top of the dumpsters. I like this kind of stuff, like kind of prop work makes me happy. And also it's an excuse to use some foliage for once. So lots of these creosote bushes popping up all over the place. Some of them sneaking a little bit into the car park itself, but we'll make sure we use these in the park as well, just to kind of tie it all together and make it feel like the park is encroaching on the car park. The park hates the car park. Car park killed the park star. I don't know, there's a joke there somewhere, but it's not a good one. I'm very tired. It's been a long day. Throwing in some habitat items. Again, kind of like with the balls, trying to pick ones that I feel like would be a logical fit for the environment anyway. So the big balls and the cardboard boxes and stuff like that. Things that the bear would naturally play with and enjoy using in this area. But that would also logically be in the area of the tires, etc., etc. Now, of course, as I say, the bear doesn't bloody move. The bear's nav mesh is fine. It can explore this entire area, but it just sits still. It does not move at all. So I'm just going to have it sitting in the dumpster area, and that's fine. It is what it is. At least they don't starve to death. If this wasn't sandbox, I'd be screwed. But yeah, it's thrown in lots of little things. Really wanted to feel kind of neglected. You know, they just kind of got to the point where they don't care much. They're just throwing stuff back here. There's not really much rhyme or reason behind it. It's just this is just the dumping ground. And that includes items to play with and would include a ton of food and stuff as well. And the natural area that would attract a rogue bear roaming around to come and have a little explore. I still like to put a bit of a gap in the fence to suggest that the bear maybe broke its way through from the park. And then maybe broke its way through the park from somewhere else, but I don't know. Only doing a single bear. It just felt more appropriate, I guess, for the sort of environment. I don't think you'd have two bears. It tends to be a solo bear in this situation, or a bear and the cubs. It doesn't tend to be two adult bears, so I thought just one sloth bear. And this is me just staring at it. It's because it just doesn't move. No matter where I put it, it doesn't move. I haven't loaded into the game since, so I'm hoping that maybe that'll fix itself with time, but I'm not full of confidence on that one, must be said. Stupid bear. But, a little bit of lights for the ranger station, which again, like I said, I'll figure out a way to block off the next habitat as well and use that twice. A little bit of light inside for a little quasi-bathroom area. Oh no, I wanted the... Okay, so what I did in that hour that you didn't see, the main thing I did was go back and edit the neon lights. So all the little bits, you know, where we rotated the LED tube and duplicated it 5,000 times, I deleted all of those. I just used the flat square, like the rectangle ones. So the shape is a little bit more haphazard. It doesn't look as good shape-wise, but it uses about 500 less LED tubes. And it isn't perfect. There's still a little flicker, but it's way less annoying than it was. So, just building a little mug pyramid. this was always the bit I was going to struggle with, and it still isn't great, and I kind of don't want to bother fixing it anymore. But, like, the interior, you know, you'd have a coffee machine, and you'd have, like, little staff areas, and maybe you'd have, like, this is what I was trying to build here. It didn't really work out. You'd have, like, a little pastry case kind of thing, or dessert tray kind of thing, you know, that kind of stuff. It's very empty behind the bar at the moment. It is something I would like to fix, but it's probably something I'll fix with workshop items rather than my own, because I am but one man, and I am not unlimited in time. But this was really helpful. I threw that person in there for the kitchen, and I didn't think to, well, I've got it there for the kitchen, why can't I throw it everywhere else? That's a billboard poster, by the way, the giant cow. The thing about the billboard posters that's so confusing is none of the... You know, you put down a poster in the game and you've got the Planet Zoo sort of... the measurement ones, like that one there, and the green ones that say, you know, screen, 2x2, 512 pixels, and it tells you the pixels that you want on Photoshop in order to make the item. There isn't an equivalent for the billboard poster, so you can't know... That's the bear. You can't know. Basically, unless you go and finagle it yourself for ages, as Josh Goran apparently did, there's no way to know how the billboard poster works. There's just no default way to know that. I don't believe Frontier have ever publicly talked about it. They just released this thing that makes no sense and expected us to deal with it. It's very silly. Thankfully people have figured it out. A little bit of neon lighting outside as well, because I love these neon lights. I think they're really cool. I tried to resist putting too many of them in. A little bit of light for the Odea dinosaur at the back. Again, it's a really interesting mix of cheesy neon and then kind of quite classical kind of vibes. Just wanted the back, want these walls to feel busy. I wanted to feel like a place with a little bit of life, you know? And apparently that's it. So I am going to pause. I am going to probably go fix a couple of those signs. You won't have seen them then anyway, because I did that post video recording. But I'm going to fix those signs and then we'll hop in game and have a look at our sloth bear who doesn't move ever. Which I say has actually made my life a lot easier in some ways. And we'll take a proper little tour of our Odea diner. I'll see you in a sec. Okay, folks, let's check out the Odea Diner. Well, actually, first, I'm just going to show you this side of town, because obviously I've thrown some Thank you for that, air freshener. I brought some extra vehicles in. Like I said, we'll give credit to those people in just a second. There's, of course, the lodge we built this time last week. And let's go check out the diner. So, from this, I think it works okay. I really was concerned that it was going to stick out a little bit too much. I threw some American flags on the ceiling, on the roof, and obviously we've got plants and trees sort of growing up from the sides. There's a little bit of wear and tear, and I think just having the vehicles kind of blends things in a little bit as well. I moved the side of the road. They were on the wrong side of the road. I'm British. We don't drive on this side. I think there's maybe too many vehicles. I'm probably going to drop a few of them, but still. So we will have a little look around the outside. That's the side of the building, the front of the building, the Odia-ish, sort of. We've got a couple of neon signs in the windows. That's the main one, and our neon signs here. And then we head inside, and here we are. So since before, I've gone ahead and just added some text onto these billboard posters. I've not sorted the billboard posters yet. It's something I need to look into a little bit more, but it's something we can definitely do down the line. I just need to fire this woman. Bear with me. I don't mind having the guy in there, but she needs firing, so she's gone. So this is the only thing I'd like to have some more stuff in this middle bit here, but it's just a difficult thing to do. It's very tedious, takes a lot of time, but it's something there. We've got all these like little, you know, little feeding facilities on top of there. We've got our custom booths and tables at the side. They've got, yeah, every now and again like a mug on them or like an umbrella, or some kids have left their toys behind. Got the lights hanging over there, our ceiling detail, our linoleum flooring, and over here. So this would be the like serving station for the kitchen. The idea is, I've not found an image that'll do it and looks good quite yet, but this screen here I'm going to replace with like an image of a kitchen, basically to just sell the idea that there's a full functioning kitchen behind this region here. I also might put a little bit of wood around that border, but we'll see. We've got some posters here from Coffee World, from actual Alan Wake 2, just kind of advertising their stuff. The Odia Diner sign in the middle. The bathrooms, which you're allowed down, but it just takes you to the bear, so you maybe don't want to go down there. And then a little notice board kind of thing. And these are the people. Now, this isn't every workshop item we've used, but the vehicles and the dumpster, it's these seven people here. I'm not going to remember exactly who did what. I'm very sorry. I should have written that down. But credit to all these people, very talented makers over on the workshop. Definitely check those names out over on the workshop. Anyways, that's the interior. Obviously, we'll come back at nighttime where it really shines, but I'm really happy with it. You know, I don't do building interiors, so to pull this off was a big thing for me. It took a lot of finagling. It took a lot of using different materials. You know, having the carpet floor thingamajiggies, the linoleum, the custom seats, the custom tables, the custom stools, this thing in the middle, the interesting ceiling, yada, yada, yada. Right, and of course, that's not all we did. So we wrap around here. Now, this is going to be the entrance to the park. So this is the little ranger station we built. And basically, there's going to be a fence here into this area, a fence here into this area, and then this bit here is going to be a park. My idea is then to throw in some buildings. I've started to flatten this area here, so I'm going to throw in some houses along here, and I'm going to throw in a bunch of houses along here, just to try to sell the idea of it being more like an actual town. You know, it's not going to be chock-a-block, but and then I think we'll do the same over here. We'll do another big building sort of around here, maybe two big buildings, and then we'll do some rows of houses, or might even do a row of houses going all the way along here and then the big building behind it, just to mix things up a little bit, and do some houses over here as well, just little things like that to try and make it feel more like an active town, because at the moment it's getting there, but there aren't enough buildings to pull it together. You know, I've done a lot of work on this place, so it's kind of wild. Anywho, so we head around here, and this is of course the car park. So is my bear still not moving? Where is my bear? Yeah, the bear still doesn't move. It doesn't matter where I put it. I'll show you. I'll throw him over here. It just doesn't move. I don't know what's going on. I think it must be because it's, I mean, this is just path. I thought they could move on path. And I'll show you the nav mesh. No, it's fine. The nav mesh is great. I specifically organized it so it could go anywhere. And the bear is unmoving. Let me just try something here. If we delete the path around the bear like that, it just doesn't move. I don't really understand what's going on. I think it must be something to do with the breakouts and the it's very strange, do you not think? If anyone has a solution, please let me know. My theory is it's to do with, because obviously the bear could just walk out. Now, I am willing to block it off. It's going to look a bit daft, but I am willing to block the bear in entirely if need be, and then turn, well, breakout's been off for ages. Yeah, I don't really understand. But the bear owns the car park, basically. So, yeah, you can see the building here. This bit wraps around. It's got the metal on the top. Got all the wires, cables supporting it, and then we've got the red underneath, which I really like. Over here, this lovely van that someone else made, it wasn't me, parked up on the no parking area. Well, the van's allowed on. This one was by John. No parking sign there. And then obviously you go into the back of the building, kind of, you know, unload the back of the van, take it up there on the trolley and drop it off inside the building. All the vehicles parked up over here on the right-hand side, little bumpers. And then we've got the actual fairly decrepit little trash area. All our dumpsters falling over, all full of equipment. Piles and piles of stuff, lots of foliage kind of encroaching from what will, of course, be a park eventually. And that sits behind there. That looks really nice at night, actually. I'm going to leave the bear in there. He's having a little nap now. The bear's going to sit in here. This is like his favourite bit. Right. He wants to hang out with all the trash. And I think that is it. And then, of course, built all this bit as well. Little pathway along here. Did a little human bit of walking path along there, and then that road's going to go back down there, so this kind of splits it, and that's where the houses are going to be. Again, there's a lot of thought in Orga. I really like how that looks from above, though, it must be said. Just having this wider car park sort of area, I think, adds a lot to it. It's getting there. It's looking more like a town. I'll show you the roof of the building as well. It's kind of like staggered approach, and obviously we've got the baby blue around the outside. Cool. Right, let's check it out at nighttime, and hopefully the lighting, it isn't perfect. It does still go a little bit crazy, but it's less crazy, you know, and that counts for a lot. So the billboard lights up at night. If you come to the side, you can see the neon signs in the windows. If we hop around the front here, I might get rid of these chief beef. Actually, I'm going to do that right now because that's annoying me. You can see the oh dear die, which I really like. Again, happy accident. It really was. But I makes me very happy. Neon signs all lit up, enticing you in, of course. And then we can head inside and have a little look inside. So you can see the lights. We get a little bit of flicker, but it's much, much better than it was. And it's more like, it depends how many lights are sort of on screen at the time. So you can see as I move closer to this area, and we get away from these neon lights. See, those are now going a bit crazy. These ones kind of chill out a little bit. So all the booths have their own little individual lights hanging over the top. But they are, of course, neon lit by the neon signs. And, of course, this on the outside. Look at that. Isn't that a vibe? It's such a vibe. I really like it. Not to big myself up or anything, but... so these are all individually lit. I could probably... Oh, there is a light in here, isn't there? Yeah, that's... Yeah, I don't want that to attract too much attention, you know? So that's just meant to suggest there's more to the building. That at the back is lit up as well. We've got all these little lights hanging down. Where's my light over? There should be... What the hell? Bear with me. I don't know where they've gone. There should be... There should be these. I definitely put these on, so I don't know what's happened to them, but they've disappeared. Let me just throw those back on. About there. Yeah, there we go. So yeah, you've got the lights of the booths, and then this individual little bar area is all lit up around the middle. I just want some like coffee machines and stuff like that in there. And then over here we've got the kitchen area. This I probably do need sort of a billboard because it's going to shine otherwise. But, these all lit up as well. The default light doesn't do much, you know, the default fan light. So I've got, I wonder if you can see it, if I just poke my head inside this. You can just about see there, that's a little extra light. All of these have those little, you know, the little conservation little garden path lights. They're hiding inside everything, basically, to make it light up properly. But yeah, really, really happy with the lighting work. The stools, that was not on purpose that they light up. You can't turn it off. You can't turn the Australian signs off. But I think it works. I think it kind of suits the vibe. But yeah, there's the diner. And let's hop outside. And have a little poke down here. So this is all lit up. It should be some windows around the outside. There's a couple of little lampposts spread around as well. Obviously, some lights at the back of this, which we added. to the van. I've also added some spotlights onto the vehicles that didn't have it because I like the look of that, basically. So a little bit dark here, but then you turn the corner and you get this really... with the bear there at the far end in the dumpsters and stuff like that, and the vehicles all lighting it up, is very much what I had in mind. So I'm really glad that worked out the way that it did. How you doing, buddy? A bit of a nightmare, aren't you, pal? Let's be honest. I don't know why you're causing such havoc. I mean, in a sense, it's good that he's walking freely, because it means he's not going to just walk out. He's not walking freely, I should say, but still. And then, that's about it. That is the Oh Dear Diner. It definitely stands out in the town, but I think as we get more buildings as well, it'll become less noticeable. Right now, it's contrasting with very little. Eventually, it'll just be this little burst of pink that you can kind of see in the town. And then, like I say, the more trees and stuff we have in the area as well, the more it'll blend in. But I think it might be the best thing I've ever built. It genuinely feels like it might be the best thing I've ever done. And even if I stole most of it, that's fine. It is what it is. Of course, we've got our traffic lights in the middle there. Town is coming together. I really do think it's going to look good when it's finished. It's just there's a lot of work still to go. You know, it's probably 50 hours or so to finish this off. It depends what we do for the houses. We do, of course, already have some houses built. We built for... we've got two types of houses. We've got these ones, but these are the Amsterdam buildings, which I don't think are appropriate. But these ones are already part of Elderwood. And I think they've probably got the right sort of aesthetic. I think these would work fine, right? I think that would be fine. I might make some little changes, but I think generally speaking, that would be okay. So I think I'm just going to use these, sort of line the wall here as far as we can over there. And then we'll back those with some trees to kind of hide the distance, and we'll do the same over here. We'll have some lining along here, and we'll you know, make it look nice, etc., etc. But I think that's gonna really help the town come to life. And this road here is the only problem child I have, because it can't really logically go anywhere. I don't mind this being a dead end. My plan for this is to build like a fake tunnel into the cliff wall here, again suggesting there's more in the future. You know, there's more park to get to, there's more distance you can get to over here. So I think we just do a big, kind of like we did, we did that ages ago. Where is it? It's back over here. It's wild flying over this map sometimes and just seeing this stuff that we built. So, I mean, look at this. We've got our apes over here. Or I can't remember what they are. They're climbing the tree like a wild kid. This is our sea mine. That was it. With their little home in the cliffs there. But the thing I'm looking for is down here. So this was our first lodge. It's okay, this one. Not as good. And then there's a tunnel down here where the car goes. This I don't love. This probably needs a bit of changing, actually, now that I look at it. But this tunnel just kind of curves around and ends in nothingness. You're not meant to ever go down there. It's just suggesting that there's... I might actually put a roof on that. That might look a lot better. We might do a tour. It might be... Maybe what we'll do, because we're kind of done until the next pack, maybe I'll throw a tour out for Elderwood 1.0 or something like that. I don't know. We're going to do a lighthouse here eventually. I'm going to put a bear in it. It's going to be like an Annihilation reference. And then obviously this all needs some rock work. There's a lot of nature work that needs doing in this section to kind of bring that up to par with the rest of the zoo. But it's getting there. It's getting there. Right. Yeah, so I won't waste any more of your time from me. And what's my sloth bear called? What are you called, buddy? Naksh. I just need you to... Problem is, because they're not moving, I can't position him in the light. He has to be thrown coincidentally into the light. There's Naksh. Naksh is having a lovely time. Not moving. If anyone knows why, please, please do let me know. But from me and Naksh, thank you very much for joining me. Next video will be post the release of the Barnyard Pack, of course. So my current plan is to do quite a small habitat that I can kind of get done relatively quickly, but I'll also do all the house work. So basically this area on the right-hand side is going to be completely done in the next pack, in the next video. And we're going to have something living in the park. I think it's going to be pigs or chickens. I'm not sure. I've got a bit of an idea for the pigs about how they eat human bodies, so I might save the pigs. But I think like a little chicken coop mini barn kind of thing that the council maintains for some reason. I just need to think of the story justification. But yeah, then we'll start to integrate other stuff. We're not necessarily just going to do barnyard animals going forward for the rest of this area. We might, you know, there's still European animals we need to integrate. So we'll see what we do. Thank you very much for joining me. If you enjoyed the video, please do throw me a like down below and a comment and all that kind of jazz. Stick around for some more Planet Zoo. I am planning to do coverage of the Barnyard Pack next week, as in showcasing the animals and showcasing the objects and all that, you know, the videos that we used to do. So stick around for that. If you are a fan, I just remembered I need to make a little change over here. But yeah, thank you very much for joining me. And I will hopefully see you all very, very soon. I just need to move these so they're on both sides. Kind of forgot about that. Boop. Also need to light them up. I might not light up both sides just for the sake of saving myself yet more lights that absolutely destroy my game. I mentioned that the sun position in this place is rough, and this is kind of what I mean. You see, the front of every building is dark, and you can't change that. There's just no way to change that. It's always going to be in darkness. There we go. Lovely. Thanks for joining me. Cheers much of as always. Bye-bye.